Secluded pub in a section of the UK, a man with a weird haircut wearing black stands in a corner shouting, "It looks distressingly like independent theatre." That said, well, this can't be independent theatre because people fucking showed up. So. That said, for a gig that I am filming, what a pleasure it is to realise that I put the camera in just such a way that the crowd cannot be seen. Literally no way that we can convince anyone online that that was a real response at all. Going forth, they'll just be like, fucking the sound editing on this is so precise. They're responding every time he finishes talking. This is the shit. Not all the time, as it turns out. Little bit of realism there thrown in at the fucking end. This is fucking brilliant. And also, I mean, goddamn. And the thing is as well, you must understand how weird it is because it's in fucking widescreen too. Because I'll tell you one thing that I fucking love. If you ever see footage of a stand-up on Instagram, right, and it's all you can see is their joke and nothing there, and it's been filmed vertically, it's because no cunt was fucking there, mate. That's why, okay? In this particular case, there are people here! Alright, now that's just flailing hands. Which is fucking helpful, it just looks like a fucking hostage situation. But we've reached that point of the orgy where one man just gets up and tells you his feelings, you know? I know you're fucking each other, but I've got an opinion! And that right there is either failed polyamory or Twitter, just in general. Actually, no, that is Twitter. You seem to be having a nice time. Well, I gave Elon Musk money, so fuck you. I've got a blue tick. Nothing else has ever sucked me. Now, Chris, thank you very much. That's right, a fucking tick reference. Why not? Also, you are a beautiful, beautiful group of people. If you people were on fire, I would throw you a stick. If you were drowning, I would piss on you. I suppose that's meant to be the other way around, but so was I when I came out of my mother, and now she walks funny. And I get turned on by being strangled. Now! It is a pleasure to be with you here in front of the radiator. Oh, always a joy to come to a gig where the background fucking runs out halfway through. That's what you want. The people over here are getting themselves a show. The people over here, it's just a man next to the bingo numbers. Also, for all of the production, I don't know if you can fucking see it, but it's very funny. Right. The joy that I have that the time, the care, the effort has gone in to learn the comedians' names and find a social media handle and put them up, and shall we add any design nows to that? No. Why would we do that when it can just look like the beginning of every 1970s Stanley Kubrick film? See, I mean, you know, like fun comedy. John Robertson, serious artist, is what that says. Very fucking upsetting. Also, the part where that's not connected to anything whatsoever. So if anyone's still over there on Twitter with the Nazis, you know, you can enter that in. Don't do anything on Instagram. Does fuck all. No, that's fine. There we go. It's just a man upset about social media. And why the fuck not? It's Wednesday night. You've seen a procession of increasingly mentally ill people. Not even a teacher, it's a lie! He said, looking at the actual child. Now, don't shrug at me, you little cunt. I say this with love. I love a tattoo that you've done with crayon. God bless you. This is aunt. You're a beautiful goddamn boy, and he knows that he's inside you. Now! Watch the fucking show. I moved house this morning. I have been living in a house with mold, and at this point, really? There's my landlord over there. We brought that in special. We gave you mushrooms you could eat. They come off the walls. We even gave you black mold to make it exotic. See? What? How the fuck did they get a ooh a noise out of it? That's when we're like, whoa, fucking edgy right there. It's progressive, shut up. The one person who clapped, well done, you're delightful. You heard black and then M and I didn't finish with metal. Sorry. I'll tell you something, the thing that you always tell when you come up to Manchester, because fuck me, I went outside and everyone looked like you two. It's that moment where you walk around going, is there a concert in town or are people just suicidal? It's both. And it could have been a concert if arts funding went up, and the suicide could, of course, be averted if there was more funding for mental health. And that's right, folks. Every once in a while, in the middle of stand-up comedy, why keep making jokes when you can make just points people should know? And then look down the barrel of the camera. I know about you people. It's like a before and after photo. I don't know which is which. Both of them are good. These two attractive men. I apologise for what I said before. Because, so help me God, you've stared at me in an unblinking way. Going, and it's all right. I am not afraid of you in any... a little bit. See? Fear a man who wears a hat indoors without a religious purpose. Do you understand? I don't fear a man who doesn't know what a ceiling does. Do you understand? Have you come in from riding a truck, mate? Not driving, riding. Have you come in from humping an engine just to feel the grunt? Getting a God bless you. Have you come in from the ventriloquism lesson? Fuck it, you get it. No! I'm also going to stop doing that because genuinely you are getting sick of it and he's not defending you. No! I misjudged the dynamic of this relationship. This is the one who's in charge. This is the brain and the crane body. Understand? There we go. There were three nerds who enjoyed that, and they were the same people who really got excited for Black Mole. Now! And fuck me! There it is, folks! Joy, you must understand, this of course is the curtain that was put up here when we thought the Nazis were going to bomb the joint. And of course, back in the 40s, they just did it in the sky. I just realised, of course, it's 2023, they could be fucking anywhere. But meanwhile, it's a wonderful thing to note, this of course used to be a white curtain, but then this didn't work and the blood spattered everywhere. Now, and the metalheads there with good, a historical death, that's fantastic. If you could just work Christopher Lee into this at some point. Just a little bit of shouting. This, I read, fuck it, pleases me. Also the fact that neither of you laugh. You just go, we liked that one. Good. Don't heckle me mocking you. No. It's just a man realising that I just work on noise more than anything else. What I am is a reverse seal. You know, a seal would do the clap. You clap for the... I'm fucking there. Just the attention sea doggo, friends. Also, one thing really pleases me, and you must understand, folks, that if this were a Western, for a start, it would have been stopped 10 minutes ago. But if this were a Western, this man would be the coolest man here, because in the middle of attacking the two boys over here, and in the middle of talking to the two gods over here, this man has just quietly reached for his beer, picked it up, put it back down, and nothing fucking went on, and I'm going, God, I think you're armed. Wait, no, fuck, also, I've just realised, oh, the Perminator. You've got a meme for a shirt, sir. How wonderful it is to know, folks, that the internet can join us here. In the room, and fucking hell, it's... I'll put it down, oh, fucking hell! I'm not gonna lie! All it's doing is just making me sound worse! The weird thing is, the algorithm will be like, stand up, stand up, stand up, stand up, and now, preaching! And the trouble with that is, I don't know if any of you have this, I don't get sent, like, the stuff I want on social media or on YouTube at all, except for Instagram, because it figured something out. Boobs! Boobs and no punchline, I'm fucking there! That's half my act! No! Fuck off, you don't know which half, my nipples are very prominent! That's why the chair. This is a nipple! You don't understand! My nipples are so savagely pierced they come through the shirt.
God! I've just realized these two are at Goth Wimbledon, is what's happening. He's failed to return the ball, he's failed in life. Good, good. The only net is our girlfriend's fishnets won't let us touch them. Good. Good. And also, you know, this is also... Hang on. Ah, that's always a good sign. When the room becomes so quiet, you can hear the hum of the air conditioning. The air conditioning that shouldn't be on because it's fucking winter. Is there a chance that the people downstairs have gone, what can we do to make this more difficult? What if you were also performing inside a malfunctioning fridge? Jesus Christ! Did you know, folks, that 100 years ago on this very day, a man with a steel anus and a prolapse. And it is said that every 100 years, the clattering sound as once again the tungsten intestine hits the floor. Oh, it'll only happen the once. Or potentially... Did anything break? Anything break?
No.
No? Oh, good. I'll tell you something. Gee, it'd be good if in about 10 seconds... It happened again. Did you know, friends, that 100 years ago, this very night, not once... Did you know? Did you know that 100 years ago, this very night, why would you bother writing? Gift of Mr. Data's anal prolapse. The name of Brent Spiner's weirdly erotic memoir. He's fully functional now. The show is working on a beautiful Venn diagram here, folks, of the deeply sexually frustrated and nerds who are intellectually satisfied by the show. What a fucking joy! And if there were any vacant seats, I would... Actually, is there polyamory in the room this evening? Friends, at the gentle sound of coughing, presumably semen. Is there polyamory here this night? No. I'm the one person. Yes. I am the one who determines the relationship structures of the crowd. Now, I have sat at the back during your bullshit about the ghost that makes the noise. If you do it a fourth time, you will test the audience's patience and he will break that cake sheet. What? I have looked at the room. I do not sense love decided via the medium of spreadsheet. I adore polyamory, I love you, but not on a Thursday. Friends, what's that?
It's Wednesday.
It's Wednesday. Yeah. I don't love you. Stick to the clapping, now! I also tell you something, that's a helpful audience member. Right there. One man going, let me tell you what's wrong with the joke you've made. The facts have let it down. Oh, you said Thursday because you thought it was amusing, but you betrayed yourself. Also, hang on. Is it Wednesday? Yeah. I'm with the wrong person. Thank you.
grandmother gave me some advice, and my mother's advice was this: don't you ever, ever, ever watch that movie, The Deer Hunter. The entire cast get buggered by hillbillies. When I was old enough, I watched that film, and no, no, they don't. They go to the Vietnam War and have a horrible time. But when you watch a movie, expect it. Moments, the hillbillies are gonna come out! It changes the fucking film! If any of you are to ever have a teenage child, show them a film and warn them that at any moment the hillbillies are coming! Lord of the Rings is 3 hours long! Genuinely, they were in a POW camp in Vietnam, and I was like, I don't know where the hill place is. Fucking hell! What's a film you would like to see ruined just by the presence of this sort of constantly sort of immaterial buggering hillbillies?
Shrek.
Titanic. Because that wouldn't be so bad. Somebody once told me Ezekiel's gonna roll me, I guess. And Titanic wouldn't be so bad. They'd go down on each other with the ship. With real love, I've also just realized that having just thrown the term hillbilly around a fair amount, I have made eye contact with the audience member wearing dungarees 6 times. This was an accident! My apologies! If these moments do happen, also, very pleasingly, are you two related out of interest?
No, that I know of.
Not that you... But you both did the same thing! Neither of you looked at each other. You both looked at this man. You went, not that I know of, without even checking. I'm not going to lie. Stand up. Stand up. Fuck off! We found your son! You don't know how lucky you are! What's that?
I'm not that old.
You're not that old? Hang on, how old are you?
Alright, I'm not old.
Friends, if at any point the world becomes more uncertain than it is, if at any point you are deeply afraid of secret police running around the streets, do not entrust your secrets to that man, who frankly followed after one thing. The simple, silly idea, this is your child. No, it isn't. Yes, it is. I know. This is beautiful. This guy is just sort of, I stood up, I sat down, you'll get on well in the system. Love the army.
Have you got muscle?
That's your motto? Get on well in the system? Really? Don't sit. Oh, wait, your motto is don't sit down? What's your motto? I keep interrupting you with my hand. What's your motto? Stand up, sit down, don't say anything. That's your motto?
I want you to understand, friend, that is genius. And I will do what I can to live my life by this superb ethos. Here we go.
When does the bus come? Oh fuck, I ruined it! That's amazing! That's genuinely fucking lovely. I had no idea. Did you folks know that today in Tibet, the Dalai Lama died?
No.
I'm joking. Is this what power is? I've never felt so much like the Daily Mail. You mean you can just say alarming shit and people will just believe you? It was merely because he must have died because he has been reincarnated this day. And of course you get to be the new Dalai Lama by picking something that belonged to the previous Dalai Lama and fuck, he loved a pint. Too many pints, and there's the cause of death. It's not Cluedo, dickhead. Had the old monkey on a Wednesday with a man in a hat.
I'm terribly sorry. That's the prompt for most of my erotic fiction.
I love a man who... End of sentence. I love that in the middle of that, bless you, because you're a little embarrassed, but it's okay, don't worry about it. What was gorgeous is, because of the brim of the hat, when you popped your head down, it was a little coquettish. It was very beautiful, the modern version of the old fan, you know? Little bit, yeah, Jane Austen's a trucker, why not? Racial pride and prejudice. Our friends, well, what a joy it is to perform in front of the area where Christ was crucified. But also friends, pleasure to look out for... Is it doing anything? Other than just making noise? Is that all it is? It's just, you know... There's no aircon in the room. It's just there to reassure you there might be. That's all this is. And also, what a pleasure. Genuinely spookier than the haunted robot's anus. Welcome to the old monkey. What have we got? Well, do you like lights?
Yes.
Well, we have some of those. Should they be covered in something that amplifies the light? No. We thought grey-black felt. Any reason particularly? Murder. Genuinely black. Also, folks, did you know?
Come lean in.
Finally, they're in shot! Oh, now the show's had a narrative arc. Bullshit. Folks, they have stopped paying me. The time has come to go in a moment. Oh no, fuck off.
No, I need this more than you. Hang on. Not all callbacks have happened. Also, the reason I was getting everyone to lean in was, did you know? That no, it's okay, I've looked a second time and it's not worth it. I understand this, friend. Friends, my name is John Robertson. On December the 10th, my show The Dark Room will do its final show for this year at the Frog and Bucket.
I tell you, if you all come, fuck me, that's a third of that room full. Friends,
just quietly. You, I wish you nothing but the best in your future. What a joy to see your future. Actually, no, to be fair, this is an amazing thing. This is your future. And also, just read this is. You two are delightful. Sitting in a perfect mirror image of each other, waving hello, not ignoring your son. Also, I'm not gonna lie, Mr. Ginsburg, I thought you were dead.
Ah, of course you clap.
Surprisingly pretentious goths.
Now!
Why did I say surprisingly?
Now!
As we crest into the 16th hour of this gig, friends, by show of hands, are there any questions? No! Of anyone who could have asked a question, I want you to understand, it was good that you put your hand up. Next time, all the way. Not gonna lie, it looked a little saluty. What is your question, sir?
Why don't you do more of your stand-up? Because the dark room's brilliant, but your stand-up is fantastic as well. Yay!
Really lovely thing to hear, had the phrase, why don't you do more of your stand-up, not been used during my stand-up. Why don't you do more of your acts? That's genuinely fucking lovely. Good, I will take that to my agents. We'll book some shit, thanking you, Fred. Right, also because, to be honest, the stand-up is two jokes and charisma. People have gotten by on less. Anyone else? All right.
Is that? Yes, all right.
Folks, my name is John.
One more question, John.
I'm trying to do my stand-up. Yes, friend.
Could all of your shows in future also end with your wife singing hits of the 80s?
Well, in a very real way, no. That would involve her being here. Like, could all of them in the future? Well, she's not here. We could get her on the phone, but she's in another time zone and working, and will be annoyed. No, you don't understand. What? A little bit of total eclipse of the heart?
Total eclipse of you, fucking.
I don't know, friends. I don't know.
Yeah. Few people know this.
But 100 years ago, on this very night, why there's not such demand for his talent. By reaching now, for the fifth time, hard
tell you, this is a Friday night crowd and a Wednesday night show. And fuck me if this isn't a Monday morning regret we're about to have.
I know it's Wednesday!
Of course it's Wednesday, that's the only day the Goths like. Now! She's a child. Now! What did you do with your evening, John? Well, I tell you what, there were a bunch of stand-ups on. Oh, thank fuck for that. Good. What did they do? Many of them jokes. Good, good. What did you do? I called out pedophilia in the Adams fam. How did it go? Oh, well, the first time, and then I drew attention to it. Oh, yeah? Why are you still talking about that? Well, are you smirking happily to yourself? Don't lean while you talk. You're leaning on me. Are you mostly doing this because... Yes, yes. Because you can't think of a fingering joke? Yes, that's right. Did you know that 100 years ago, don't fuck this up, on this very night,